Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Stuart Green, who is the CEO of Zoo Digital. Stuart, it's great to have you on the line, and it's been a little while since we last heard from you. So perhaps you'd just like to start today's interview by giving us a little bit of an overview of what Zoo does.
Sure. Yeah. Thanks very much for having me. So Zoo's a tech-enabled provider of services to the entertainment industry. We work for large streaming services and big producers of entertainment content, such as TV series and feature films. And what we do for them is take their finished programs and do what's necessary to get those programs onto streaming platforms so they can be enjoyed by audiences, you know, wherever they may be around the world and through whichever channel that our customer wants to deliver that. So there are obviously quite a lot of different streaming services now, and there are lots of countries in which that this kinds of content is being consumed. So we provide all that's necessary, all the technical things and all the creative things that are necessary to get that content. And a big part of that is localization. So we subtitle and dub the programs into different languages. And we also do the technical things necessary to make sure that those programs work properly and smoothly when they go onto a streaming channel.
So Stuart, is this something that's started off in one way and has gradually just grown over the years? I know you've been going for around about 20 years now already.
Yeah, it's been a long history. We started out as a software company, and our, you know, innovation and technology is in our DNA. And as such, we're sort of we have a different take on this industry and the way in which these services can be delivered. In our early days, we were licensing software, but around 2006, 2007, we pivoted to be a company that delivers services. But those services are differentiated through the benefits afforded by the proprietary software that we created. So essentially, we stopped licensing software. Instead, we chose to retain that software to give us our competitive advantage. Working in this industry, the forerunner to streaming was DVD and then Blu-ray disc. And so in our earlier days, lots of the work that we did was all around those formats. Netflix launched their streaming service in 2007, and that sort of paved the way for this transition to streaming. But it actually took 10 years for the industry to transition. And that's really all to do with the internet, actually, at the time, not having enough capacity to deliver high quality videos streamed into all our households. So it was actually only in 2017, really, that streaming started to take off and its growth replaced the declining growth in the decline in sales from sort of traditional DVD, Blu-ray type distribution. So it's been a long journey. We've transitioned along the way, but now since 2017, you know, we have a proposition that is, you know, very much focused around the needs of our large content customers to help them get their content onto the streaming platforms. And with our tech-enabled service, we're very clearly differentiated from others who operate in this space.
Well, Stuart, it's obviously enough of a value proposition that you have now signed another deal with a major Hollywood studio that must not be named. So perhaps you'd like to tell us about that news from this week.
Yeah, sure. As I mentioned, there are lots of streaming services around the world. There are hundreds of them, actually. But there are a relatively small number that are truly global, you know, where you have a company that has produced a service and is delivering that service into many different countries. In the US, there are a couple of companies that have, two or three companies that have already done that. And there are some other big media companies that have started to offer a service in North America and are now beginning to look at rolling those services out into other countries as well. So we are ideally placed to address the needs of those large clients, those large producers of content who are looking to reach audiences in many different countries, because we can offer the full range of services that they need, and we can offer those services into all the different languages. So what we do is highly sought after by these big players. And as they go through that rollout process, obviously they need the support in order that they can offer language versions in lots of different languages for lots of different countries. Now, one of the things that sets us apart from our competitors, of course, is that we are very tech enabled. We have an internal research and development team that is innovating and creating new technologies to help us do what we do and to help our customers become more efficient. And one system that we have developed is called Zoo Studio. And this is a system that helps our customers to be very efficient in the way in which they place the orders and manage the work that they are outsourcing to vendors such as Zoo. It's, you know, when they produce, say, a TV show and they want to get that show onto their platform in all around the world, there will literally be thousands of individual items that need to be ordered. And so for a, you know, for a media company that is managing that, that's a pretty complex thing to deal with, and made all the more challenging by the fact that, of course, when content is released on streaming services these days, it goes in all languages simultaneously. It's available all around the world on the same day. So there's an enormous amount of work that has to be condensed into a very short period of time. So our Zoo Studio platform, which has been adopted by this client that we announced this week, makes that process very, very efficient and very scalable. And this is the second major US media company that has adopted this platform to use as the backbone of their operations for preparing content for global distribution.
Understood, Stuart. Well, congratulations on that news, and I'm going to wrap it up there. So thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thanks for having me.